Hi students, good morning once again. Welcome to the another session of rational numbers in your class mathematics. That is the first chapter. That's good. Keep watching my channel and my videos. Thank you so much. This is Srinivas from ZHSWPR. Shall we start the session today of rational numbers? Okay. We are going to start today now. The rational numbers. So far, we have discussed about the rational number, isn't it? Now today, we are going to discuss about the properties of a rational numbers. What are the properties of a rational numbers? Properties of rational numbers. Before going to see, for these properties, first property is closure property. Now this closure property we have to verify for plus. See, there is plus symbol is there, and we have to verify for minus, and we have to verify for into, and we have to verify for divided by. Plus, minus, into, divided by. That means addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So closure property should be verified for addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Okay, shall we continue? Okay, let us continue now. See, whole numbers. First of all, take whole numbers and closure property. How to take whole numbers? How to verify the closure property of whole numbers? After verifying the closure property for whole numbers and integers, then we'll go to rational numbers. So let us see now, verifying the closure property for whole numbers. For any two whole numbers a comma b, a star b is also a whole number. See, what did I give? For any two whole numbers a comma b, a star b is also a whole number. What the star represents? A star b. This star represents plus or minus or into or divided by anyone. The star represents plus, minus, into or divided by anyone. You can use it. Okay. So let us see now. There is a table. I am giving operations, what example and remarks. See, each one I am giving one by one. First I will give operation, example and remark. Okay. See, first operation is addition. Let us see the closure property for whole numbers under addition. Okay, for addition, how to operate this closure property? See one example. 2 comma 3 are whole numbers. Let us take 2 and 3. 2 and 3 are whole numbers only, no? So 2 and 3 are whole numbers. Then add. I am verifying this one for addition. Add 2 plus 3. See addition, no? 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. Whether 5 is whole number or not? Yes, 5 is a whole number. That is why it is also a whole number. See, I have taken two whole numbers. Then its addition becomes a whole number. That is why addition is closed in whole numbers. Addition is closed in whole numbers. Okay? Why? Because when you take two whole numbers, the addition of those two whole numbers becomes a whole number. Yes, now it is satisfying. Yes, addition of whole numbers is closed. Closed means closure property. Okay, let us go to the next addition, that is subtraction. Let us go to the operation subtraction. Now we will see whether it is satisfying or not. Whether we can say yes or no. That's what. Okay. Take 5 comma 7 are two whole numbers. See, 5 and 7, two whole numbers. Then subtraction. So 5 minus 7. Subtraction. 5 minus 7 means minus 2. But this minus 2 is not a whole number, na? There are no negative numbers in the set of whole numbers. Yes or no? There are no negative numbers in the set of whole numbers. That is why this minus 2 will not be there in whole numbers. So even if you take two whole numbers, these two whole numbers subtraction is not a whole number. See, taken two whole numbers, but when you subtract, you are not getting a whole number. That is why this closure property is not satisfied in whole numbers under subtraction. Under subtraction. So here we will write addition is, subtraction is not closed in W. W means whole numbers. Not. See, I have given red mark, highlighted. Why? Because it is no. Subtraction, whole numbers, closure property is not satisfied. This is no. Okay. Addition, yes. Subtraction, no. All these are for whole numbers and closure property. Okay. Let us see the third one. Third one is multiplication. So multiplication of whole numbers. Take one example. 4 and 8 are whole numbers. 4 into 8, that is 4 8s are 32. Again, 32 is a whole number. You can take any whole number here. You can take any whole number. Either 4, 8 or 10, 15 or 120 or 28, 13. Like that, any whole number you can take. If you multiply, you will get a whole number only. 4 8s are 32. This is also a whole number. So like addition, multiplication also satisfies closure property. So here we can write multiplication is closed in W. Multiplication is closed in W. That means whole. So addition is closed, S. Multiplication also, S. But subtraction, it is no. For whole numbers, which property? Closure property. Okay, na? Now let us go to the fourth operation, division. See the division operation. 3 comma 8 are whole numbers. See, 3 and 8 are whole numbers. Now 3 divided by 8. We cannot divide 3 by 8. Okay. 3 and 8 are taken as whole numbers, but when you divide, the answer is not a whole number. It is not a whole number. It is a rational number, isn't it? Why? Because it is in the form of P by Q. So it is a rational number. So division also, closure property is not satisfied in whole numbers. So here we can write division is not closed in whole numbers. So addition is closed, S. Subtraction is not closed, multiplication is not closed, but multiplication is closed. I mean closure property. Closed means closure property satisfied. Okay, division is not closed. So which are S and which are no? Addition and multiplication, S. S, satisfied. Subtraction and division, no, not satisfied. I hope you understood, children. Okay, we'll go to the next one. Whole numbers over. Next one, we'll go to integers. The same closure property we will again observe about integers. So let us observe. For any two integers, same a comma b and a star b is also an integer. Take two integers a and b. You make any operation, either plus or minus or into or divided by. You make any operation, again you will get an integer. If you get like that an integer, then it is closure property satisfies. Shall we observe now? Take a table again. Operation, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, example and remarks. Okay, let us take first one, addition. Take an example, minus 2. See, these are integers. Since these are integers, we can take negative number also. So minus 2 comma 3, it is an integer. Minus 2 is an integer, 3 is an integer. Now for addition, so add. Minus 2 plus 3 is equal to 1, because 3 minus 2, that is equal to 1. It is also an integer. 1 is an integer. So addition satisfies. Two integers are taken. See here, two integers are taken. The result is an integer when you add. So when two integers are taken, after addition, if you get the result as an integer, then it is closure property satisfied. Addition is closed in Z. Z means integer. So closure property S satisfied. Go for next one, subtraction. Take an example, minus 5, 7 are two integers. Subtraction, so take subtraction, minus 5, minus 7, this is minus 12. Minus 12 is also an integer now. Why? Because in integers, negative numbers are existing. So very good. When two integers taken, then the result also is an integer. So this is also satisfying. Subtraction is closed in Z. Yes, S. For addition, S. For subtraction, S. Which property? Closure property. Okay. Now, in integers, third one, multiplication. Take an example, 4 into minus 8. That is, 4 8s are 32. Minus 32 is an integer. 4 and minus 8 are integer. Then after multiplying, the resulting number is also an integer. So it is also satisfying. Multiplication is closed in Z, integers. Very good. Addition is closed, S. Subtraction is closed, multiplication is closed. Okay, let us take the fourth one, division. So division of an integer, closed. So again, same, take the same number, minus 3 comma 8. Now divide minus 3 by 8. Minus 3 by 8, this is not an integer. Observe properly, this is not an integer. This is a rational number. So division is not closed in Z. Division is not closed in Z. So for integers, closure property, addition, subtraction, multiplication, S, satisfying. But for division, no. Okay, children, have you understood now? For closure property, we have seen for whole numbers and again integers. For whole numbers, addition and multiplication, yes. Subtraction and division, no. Okay, children, so I hope you understood. Then we will go to the rational numbers. So now we have learnt about closure property under addition, subtraction, multiplication and division in whole numbers and also in integers. We have not entered into rational numbers. Just we have seen for whole numbers and also for integers. Is it or not? So in the next session, coming session, we are going to learn about closure property of rational numbers. Okay, children, keep watching. Don't miss it. I'll be coming again. I hope you will be waiting for the next session. Thank you. Thank you so much. I remain. This is Srinivas from JetPages. Double 4. Thank you. Bye.